Hi everybody, good afternoon. Welcome to the Machine Learning Series 3 webinar. So it's still 2:59, so we'll wait till 3:05 and then we'll start the session. So welcome everyone, good afternoon. Hope you guys are able to hear me. Good afternoon, people. Okay, great. Now the people are joining slowly. So we have about 62 people. So a lot of them are saying good afternoon, like Chaitra, Gangadhar, Varun. Good afternoon, everyone. Warm welcome to the session 3. We are expecting, you know, few more participants to join the session. So until then, we'll wait. Just 5 minutes, we'll wait up to 3:05. Yeah, Sanjay, thanks for confirming. Yeah, great. I think people are able to hear me. Sanjay says we can hear. Thank you. Thank you for confirming. Yes, Raghu also says he can hear. Okay, Raghu is our SME, Mr. Raghu. Hey, hi, Devesh. Good afternoon. Hi, Gayatri. Good afternoon. Ashok. Good afternoon, Ashok, Sujai. Yes, you can hear me. Thanks for confirming. Yellappa, Sanjay, Gangadhar, Chaitra, Varun. Okay, good, good numbers. I know joining in. Great. So, all right. So, I just want to, you know, just give a quick, I wanted to make a quick announcement because a lot of times we get emails telling that people, you know, want the recording of the session, whether the record sessions are getting recorded or not. So, yes, to answer that question, we record the sessions. Every webinar session we record. And also for convenience of all the participants who have registered, who are not able to attend, who have attended and want to go through the session, what we do is we have created a web page on a website. So there we, you know, keep providing the links of YouTube and Facebook because we upload all our recordings in YouTube and Facebook. So I'll just quickly share my screen and show you where exactly you can go and find. Hope you are able to see my screen. Yes, right. So this is the place where we actually provide all the you know, recordings. So till now we have done 2 sessions. This is a 3rd session. Today is 14th, right? So once the session is over, we will be uploading the Facebook link here, and then the YouTube link also. All right. So the previous session, if you want to go through, so we had done some Python session and one more related to machine learning. Those recordings are available here. So in case if you want to, you know, subscribe to a YouTube channel or follow on the Facebook, automatically when we upload any recording, new recording now or in the future, all the notification you will get and you can, you know, actually access those recordings, right? So for your convenience, if you click here also, it will take to our Facebook page or maybe here so that you can easily access the recording, or in multiple places you have where you can go and access, or specific recording of 30th, if you want to check here, you can actually go and access it, right? So today's recording will be available around 4:30, 5 o'clock, which should be max, it should be available for you to, you know, access. So, and also at the same time, you know, Mr. Raghu, who is our SME, who is actually going to deliver the session and is also been delivering all this 2 sessions earlier, he's also going to conduct a machine learning training. So that will be starting from this Friday. So this is a 60-hour program. So total, you know, 6 weekends we are going to conduct. So totally 12 days, 6 weekends, meaning Saturday, Sunday, Saturday, Sunday, 12 weekends we are doing. And for all the webinar participants, we are offering for just 7,695. This is a discounted offer, which is inclusive of GST. Okay. So the actual price is 14,750. We are giving it for 7,965. If you want to find out any more details about the course, here you can download the course curriculum. Okay, it will take to our course curriculum page. Just like this, if you click. Okay, because my screen sharing is only to this page, so that's why I'm not able to see. So it will take to a different page where you can see the content, what we are going to cover, what hands-on we are going to do. All those things are mentioned over here. And if you want to enroll, you can have an enroll button and you can enroll it. So our training, what Mr. Raghu is going to do, will be a virtual training. And it's completely practical, hands-on. Every session has a hands-on session. He will demo the concepts. And the same thing, he will allow you to practice in the session. And moreover, we record the session every day. So once you practice in the session, and once you after the session, if you want to practice, and if any point you missed out, you can go and look back in the recording. Or in the future, maybe 6 months, 1 year, or 2 years, or 3 years later, if you want to refresh yourself, the recordings will be available for you to go and access it. So once you complete the training, we also provide certificate as well. So anybody interested, actually, they can go and actually, if any queries you have, you can reach us out. So myself, I'm Kumar, and this is my number and email address. You can reach us out. Okay. So that's the thing. And for easy access for the webinar recording, what you can do is you can go to a web page like skillupright.com. And if you go to this tab, webinar recording, so here we have recordings for ML and Python. So AWS also, we have a training. So we were supposed to start last weekend, but because of some trainer's personal emergency, we could not start. We are starting this weekend. So if anybody interested, they can get the details here and they can join the AWS program as well. So I think it's already 3-6 now. Hope you guys are able to get it, like, about the recording. So we'll kickstart the session. So meanwhile, what I'll also do is I'll just make a link available, so that on the below the chat section, so that you can access it. I mean, you can just save the link and for your future reference to access the recording. Okay, that's all from my end in terms of the recording. Just wanted to clarify with everyone. So like the last session, Mr. Raghu, who was our SME on the machine learning and Python, he's again the same SME will be delivering today's session as well. So like always, like we introduce, is a veteran in the IT industry, more than 25 years of experience. So he has worked in multiple MNCs, and 4 to 5 MNCs. And at the same time, before he could join the corporate world, he was also a professor in an engineering college about 7 years. And then he got into corporate world, where he has worked on real-time projects, and he's also doing a lot of trainings and consulting work all this while. So today he's going to deliver an another machine learning training today. That's all from my end. Mr. Raghu, you can take over from here. Over to you, Mr. Raghu. Mr. Raghu, can you hear me?
Are you able to hear me?
Yes, yes, Mr. Raghu, I'm able to hear you.
Okay. Thanks, Kumar, for the introduction. And also thanks to the participants for attending the third webinar on the series of machine learning. And let me just quickly go through the last two sessions, what we have covered, and then jump into the machine learning topics. So let me share my screen, and when I share my screen, I won't be able to see the chart window. Just if you can quickly tell me once whether you're able to see, or if in between if there is any problem, you can actually chart, or if one of you can even inform me, then it would be great. Yeah, so let me share my screen. Hope you are able to see my screen. Can I get the confirmation, quick confirmation?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Let me go ahead. Yeah. So today we will be discussing about the machine learning. And the introduction about me already Kumar has done. I worked with companies like Cisco, CSC, ICC group of companies, and the First Apex, which is now NTT Data. I worked on many domains like including BFSI, public sector, government projects. So currently I'm also into consultant to Atal Tinkering Labs and also for multiple companies. And I worked on many technologies, started with Java and then moved on to different technologies as I got the opportunity. Yeah. So coming to this agenda for today's session, I will be giving an introduction to what is AI, ML and deep learning, because most of the times these terminologies are interchangeably used, what exactly it is and what kind of applications are already being built or people are talking about or work is going on in the area of artificial intelligence and bit history of AI. And also we will go into the machine learning deep dive, in the sense we will take one or two algorithms of machine learning, and also I will tell you about the domain specific applications of machine learning, and we will be having a hands-on session on this. So this is the pretty much agenda for today's class. So what is artificial intelligence? It is nothing but we want the machine to mimic the cognitive functions of the human being. So what is the cognitive function? This is the unique ability of the human being to think, to analyze, to learn with the experience, right? So that is what we human being are good at it, or we are good at it solving the problem. So can we make a machine which can help us or which can mimic those kind of a things rather than explicitly being programmed? So that is what was the aim of human being from long years. So that is where this terminology is coined, called artificial intelligence, which basically is the natural, it is a contrast to the natural intelligence displayed by the human being. It is the artificial intelligence. So cognitive function, as I told, it involves the process of thinking and reasoning. So that is where we good at it. And when we look at the human being, like we have very good sense organs, right? We do a lot of things in terms of vision, in terms of speech, right? Other than and reasoning. So there are so many things we do. So it would be quite a task if we want to make the machine do all those things or part of it. When we look at AI, ML and DL, so most of the time it is interchangeably used. So it all started with artificial intelligence, where we want to build any kind of a machines, or where we want to build a system which can mimic the functioning of the human being. That is what is artificial intelligence all about. Under that branch, we have two other things, machine learning and deep learning. So what is machine learning? So it is the ability of a machine, of a system, to improve the task which does with the experience. Like as we do, if I do the same task or if I do the similar kind of a task, with experience, we'll be doing in a really better way, right? In the same way, it is a statistical technique which enables the machine to improve its ability to perform the task. That is what we call it as machine learning. One subset of machine learning is nothing but deep learning. So deep learning, again, here also we'll be using kind of algorithms. So which can do things like image processing or like speech recognition, but the way it does is in a different way. As a human being, we have like our brain, powerful brain, which is a network of biological neurons, right? So it is a network of biological neurons. So as we have the network of biological neurons, suppose if I look at some fire happening at some time, or like if we try to cross a road, suddenly something comes up. So a lot of things happens, like I sees, and then suddenly it sends the signal to the brain. Brain is a complex system. So it is a neural network. So if we are able to solve any kind of a problem by simulating the way neural network works, so that is what we call it as deep learning. That is a subset of the machine learning. So here now what we are talking about is only about the machine learning, not about the deep learning. That itself is another course altogether. So artificial intelligence broadly helps in different ways. One of them is the machine learning. And again, we have some kind of a classification, which we call it as supervised machine learning, unsupervised machine learning, and then reinforcement learning. Another one is the deep learning. And there is also a classification of natural language processing. So what is the natural language processing? As a human being, we speak, we read, right? So can we make the machine to do the same thing? So that is what is the natural language processing. So as you would have rightly identified, so we already have nowadays machines which can do, or assistants which can do the natural language processing. Say like Google Assist is one of them, or Amazon Alexa. They're already an example of natural language processing, right? And also another important area is the vision, like image recognition. So identifying the images, extracting the information from the images, that is one of the part of the applications of artificial intelligence. And other than that, text to speech, speech to text. So that is there in the Google has a lot of such tools where we can do the so suppose say now earlier we had an assistant who can take down the notes. So now it is not like you can use the Google and then you can dictate and that can be translated into the English or any other language, right? So speech to text and text to speech. And other than that, we have robotics, which will be extensively used in the industry for where most of the technologies converges. So like Internet of Things, artificial intelligence, machine learning, those kind of things, analytics converges. So that is what we call it as industry 4. That is where our industry is moving towards, especially the manufacturing industry.
Hi guys, please wait, sir, you're facing some technical issue, so we'll connect back in 1 or 2 minutes. Please wait, power is gone actually. Please wait, we'll come back in 1 or 2 minutes. Wait for 2 minutes, we'll back.
Okay, are you able to hear me? Yeah.
Yes, sir. Now
there was some network problem. Yeah, let me just connect back. Yeah. Sorry for the same. Hope you are able to see my screen. Hope you are able to hear me. Can I get the confirmation?
Yes, sir. Now is good.
Okay. 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 Fine. Okay. So I was talking about the different products which are already being used by Google, which has AI into it. One of them, as I told you, like the mail, and also if you start typing the mail, suddenly you can see it starts typing the sentence. So that is one of the example. Other than Google AdWords, and then like offensive content identification in the YouTube driving. So there are lot of like each of the products are mostly using these AI capabilities. And also Google has tied up with Nest, and it is coming up with a Google Home, right? So those are all the examples of the AI or ML which is being built into the Google products. Other than that, we nowadays we have all these personal assistants which is already built into either into our computer or our into desktop or our into laptop, right? And also into our mobile. So those are all the few examples of the personal assistant. And the other examples, if you can see, is any of the recommender systems. So whenever you try to buy something from a from online, right? So either Flipkart or Amazon, there is a recommender system which says the person who also bought this things. That is example of ML. Same thing is applicable in the Netflix. If you have seen Netflix, they also recommend based on what kind of movies you watch, they are going to do the recommendation. And one of the example is the Facebook object detection, as we already know. So tagging of the people, and also you can tag various elements, right? Various things like be it a car or a sky or anything, you can tree or anything. It is an example of ML. And nowadays we have healthcare chatbots, right? Now chatbot is an example, extensive example of the AI. So where this chatbots gets trained themselves as and when we keep chatting, interacting with this, it with the experience, it tries to understand, okay, this is how I have to interact, and also try to understand the language. And basically, like, we can write the language in different ways. We can use the language or we can in a different ways, still it tries to understand the context. Context is very important. That is what is the example. Other than that, the AI is not new, actually. It started way back in 1957 only. It has moved all the way. But why now? Why is that AI, ML, every people are talking about? So because of the two things, one is the computing power. Nowadays we have the computing power and better processors we are getting at the cheaper rate. Second one is the availability of the data. Now the data is available because all these things, so it has to learn by experience means. So how we can make the machine learn? Only by providing data, right? Data sets. So now we have the data set because of the explosion in the internet, because of the social media, because of anything, that we have huge data. So because of that, this is coming into dominance or predominance. This is the first best thing happened is in 1997, where the Deep Blue, which is the IBM chess, computer beat the human champion, and also AlphaGo, that is again one of the games similar to the chess. And similarly, we have IBM Watson, Google driverless car, and all those things. So it is picking up. Things are moving ahead. It is not just a fiction. If we can look at the real examples like AI in the news, so it's already there. For example, our KSRTC buses have for few of the lines installed the sensor-based anti-collision devices. So where when they are driving, Suppose the, it senses what InCut does is it basically senses the phase. It recognizes the phase if there is any blink, or if the blink rate is not proper, and it will identify whether a driver is drowsing or not. And also if the vehicle is moving very fast, and if then it tries to apply the reduce the speed and things like that. So this is not a fiction, and this is KSRTC got the award for this. And also similarly, like nowadays with the integration of many technologies. So if you have read the news, like there was one person who was there in near Manyata Park Tech Park, and he had a house near it, near Manyata Tech Park, but he gone to US, and some burglars came and tried to break his house. And suddenly he has installed a camera, and with the sensors and all, he got the notification in the US, and he alerted the people here in India, and they called the police, and they are able to catch the thief. So these are all the few examples which I am giving. So that's why it is not just a fiction, and things are really moving ahead. So that is the first part of the introduction where I introduced into the AI. Now let us get deep into the ML, and let us try to understand what is ML and what are the different types of ML and things like that. And then we will move ahead with the hands-on session. So the second part is where I will be talking about the ML part. So if you look at broadly, the machine learning is classified into three types. One is called as the supervised machine learning. Another one is the unsupervised machine learning. And third is the reinforcement learning. So again, supervised machine learning is classified into two things. One is called as the regression. Another one is the classification. Similarly, unsupervised machine learning is divided into two things, dimensionality reduction and then clustering. So let us exactly understand what is this supervised machine learning and how machine can learn and all. So with a known example. So supervised machine learning, as you would have identified, there is a supervisor who will facilitate the machine to learn. So let us take the example. Let us say you have a small kid in your house, or when we were small kids, how we have learned all these English alphabets, or Kannada, or your mother tongue, whichever the alphabets we have learned. Let us try to recall and let us try to identify. So what our parents would have done is they would have shown a picture of apple. And they said A for apple, right? Similarly, B for ball, C for cat. So that is what they have done. So what is that? That is nothing but precisely supervised learning. What is a supervised learning? Here we have some data. The data is in the form of an image. And this data is the labeled data. So we call it as a labeled data because it is A for apple. Apple is already labeled. So what we have done, well, we understood, okay, this picture with this color means it is apple, right? Similarly, ball. So now with that understanding, how the machine supervised learning could be used is, suppose to your house, your neighbor comes or your relative comes, they also have a kid, they come with a new book. They come with a new book, and in that book, they also have the image, and they will ask your kid or their kid showing that picture. They will ask whether is it a ball, is it apple. So they may be having a bigger apple, or maybe they are having a bit different colored apple. Still, if your kid is able to say that, yes, this is an apple, that means your kid has learned. Right. So in the same way, supervised learning is like a teacher who is holding a stick and telling this means this with the given data. And when we give the new data set, then if the machine is able to learn and understand, that is what is called as the supervised machine learning. So that is an example of a supervised machine learning. So we have input data, we have labeled data, and then we have the output. So this is what is supervised machine learning. Coming to the unsupervised machine learning, what is unsupervised machine learning? So in unsupervised machine learning, here we do not have the labeled data. In the sense, let us say, again, let us get back to the same situation where as when we were a kid. So we know like some set of fruits. Maybe we were introduced to some set of fruits. Suddenly your neighbors or relatives comes and they come and they come with new set of fruits, which we have not seen at all. Okay, then if we ask the kid to organize that fruit or just try to play with that fruit, probably what it would have done is it would have organized the fruits, or it has arranged the fruit based on some characteristic, based on the similarity, right? So it would have organized, maybe based on the color or based on the shape, it would have organized the fruits in that way. So this is what we call it as unsupervised machine learning. There is no supervisor here. There is no supervisor here, but it tries to understand and tries to group the things. So that is what we call it as the unsupervised machine learning. Or suppose if I have to give another example, let us say there is an exam and teacher will tell, okay, this is the syllabus. I don't know what is the question I am going to give it to you, but you learn yourself. In a sense, they would have given some notes or they would have thought, but they are not sure like what kind of questions they are going to give. So you have to learn, you have to prepare, and then you have to do. Okay, that is what we call it as an unsupervised learning. So this is the another type of learning. The third type of learning is a reinforcement learning. So what is a reinforcement learning? This we learn on the go, in the sense, let us say how we would have learned to ride a bicycle, right? When we are riding a bicycle, even though you would have got the training saying that this is what you have to do, this is the pedal, this is the brake, and you have to go like this, but still, when you got into a real situation, you have to learn, right? Suppose suddenly you go to a place where a lot of traffic is there, then you will try to learn. Okay, so the vehicles are coming so fast, I have to move left. Or suddenly some vehicle is coming from the front or from the left, I have to apply the brake, right? Suppose you learn with that, and if you do in a better way, then you will be rewarded. If you are not done in a better way, you will be given a feedback. You will be given a continuous feedback. So what you are doing is correct or not. So that is what is called as the reinforcement learning. The example of reinforcement learning in the real world is like driving a driverless car. Yeah. So that is an example of a reinforcement learning. Again, coming to what is a supervised learning and what is the real example of a supervised learning is, suppose we want to predict something, predict the price of a stock, then it is a supervised learning. Unsupervised learning is, let us say we launch a new product, we wanted to know like what kind of people are able to buy that product. We cannot say even this particular person is going to buy, but we can segmentize. Okay, we can say, okay, the people who are in this particular area, particular geography, with this salary level or with this intent, they are going to buy. So that is what is the unsupervised learning. So these are the broad three categories. One is called as the supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and then the reinforcement learning. So most of the machine learning algorithms so far, whatever has come up or whatever is being used, mostly are into unsupervised learning. A lot of things are happening in the unsupervised learning area and the reinforcement learning. So this is where a lot of things are happening, but most of the cases so far is in the area of supervised learning. Now, how do we identify what kind of learning it is, what kind of algorithms or what kind of type of machine learning? So given a question, we have to ask, if the question is this A or B? Suppose I'm working on a project, if I had to do something like is this or that, that means that is a classification. Again, in supervised machine learning, we have two things. One is called as the classification, another one is the regression. What is a regression? Predicting a value. As I told you, predicting the value of a stock is a regression. If the question is how much or how many, then we call it as regression. If the classification is this or that, that is called as the classification. Again, further, we can also in that, is it something weird? So that we call it as an anomaly detection. And if the question is like organizing something, how this is organized, That is an example of a clustering algorithm. Clustering is part of the unsupervised machine learning. And if the question is, or if you come across a situation where we say what to do next, what should I do next is nothing but the reinforcement learning. Like you are driving a vehicle, what to do next? Suddenly something comes. So that is what is an example of a reinforcement learning. Another example of reinforcement learning is like playing the chess game. So that is an example of a reinforcement learning. So these are all the broadly the machines are classified. I mean, learning is classified into this. Yeah, so classification algorithm. So as I told you, is yes or no kind of a thing. Is it cold? Or there may be multiple classifications like yes, no, or maybe, or multiple values. And broadly, there are so many machine learning algorithms are there. And this is an set of algorithms which you try to put. Again, further, there are something which can be called as unsupervised, semi-supervised learning. So in case of the supervised, as I told you, there are two things. One is a continuous target variable that is called as the regression. Another is a classification, which is a categorical target value. So example could be like housing price prediction or medical imaging. That is where is the classification comes into picture. Customer segmentation or market basket analysis. So the analyzing like who is going to buy what, the person who has bought this also bought this, that is some unsupervised machine learning. Here again, some kind of a text classification or lane finding on the GPS. Further, it is classified categorical target variable like classification and clustering. And the reinforcement learning is like, as I told you, driverless car or optimized marketing. So that is some of the example of the reinforcement learning. So there are quite a lot of algorithms here. When we say machine learning, we are going to use these algorithms. So some of them are like linear regression, logic regression, and then you would have heard about the decision trees, support vector machine, Bayesian networks. And then further, when you get into the deep learning, then we will be using artificial neural networks. And in terms of the clustering, there is something called k-means clustering. And there are other things like dimensionality reduction is called principal component analysis. So there are so many, quite a lot algorithms are there. So when we say machine learning, what is that we will be doing is we are trying to first analyze the data, which I spoke about in the last webinar, where we are going to do after the data analysis, then we will be taking one of the machine learning, we are applying the machine learning model and try to solve the problem. So now to help us, Python has a library called scikit-learn, which comes up with so many algorithms, which is already there. At this point in time, we should be able to identify which algorithm to use and what is best suitable and how to use it. Maybe you are come across with some situation where you have to write your own algorithm. So that is where you can lead your career path in terms of the data scientist. But most of the cases, it would be good if you understand the algorithm and if you understand and where to apply. So already these algorithms are there. And again, from the perspective of the machine learning, what we should know also is the pandas, which is which will be helpful for data manipulation analysis, which I spoke in the last session. And another one is the matplotlib. So that is for the, and another thing is the NumPy, which is a scientific computing package of Python, which mostly works on the arrays. And then the matplotlib, that is for the visualization. So those are all, again, we will be using in the machine learning. And when we say machine learning, it is one of the part of a bigger project. Let me give you a bigger picture. So what is a bigger picture is, say, this is what. So when we say a project, when we get into a project, mostly that is part of a data science project. Why? When we start any project, because of the business reason, right? Business requirement. So what would be the business requirement? Maybe there are telecom companies. So customers of a telecom company is moving to another company. So they wanted to know why people are moving. That is where this project starts. Then they get into taking the data, analyzing the data, where they will hire some kind of a data scientist and then analyst. They will do the all kind of data gathering. Data gathering could be from so many places. It could be the data which is stored in the database, which could be stored in what you can call it as a in a semi-structured data, which could be a logs or which could be data available in a social media network. So they're going to put the data and they're going to do the analysis. After that only the machine learning model comes into picture. So this is the third part where we will be doing the, we are going to use a particular algorithm and then we are trying to solve that particular problem based on the kind of a problem. And once it is done, then comes the data engineering part. That means we are applying an algorithm to solve some kind of a problem. And once it is done, we build a product. It could be a mobile app, it could be a web app, and we are going to deploy and we are going to do this. So machine learning is one of the part of the big project of a data science. Okay, so that is what machine learning all about. So now let us quickly move to the practical part and try to understand simple thing of a machine learning, where I would be demonstrating you how to use what is called as a linear regression. So usually you would have come across basic things about the linear algebra and all. So what are the things required for a machine learning is see good understanding of the programming language, data structure of the programming language, maybe Python. Python is the option. So you should know like basically how to use a dictionary list. Other than that, after that, bit understanding of the statistics and then linear algebra and then probability. A bit of integration and all. So these are all required when you want to excel in this field, but you need not to worry too much about it. But understanding of this much be essential. So now let us try to go with what is called as the one of the first algorithm usually we start with. It is like a hello world of machine learning, which is a linear regression. So what is a linear regression? Let us try to understand this with an example. Now I will be demonstrating using the Jupyter notebook. So let me go to the Jupyter notebook. So let me open the Jupyter notebook. So what is that we are trying to do in this? Let me show you the data set, very simple data set. I have this data set, which is the home prices. So very simple data set. We are not having a huge data set to demonstrate this. So we have two parameters. One is the area, another one is the price. So what is this? This is about a home price or a plot price or a flat price. So if the area of a particular plot is this much, and this is what is the price. So you have been asked to build a model to predict the price in case I am going to give you an area. In case I am going to give you an area, you should be able to predict the price. Here we are going to use the linear regression. Linear regression is, here we have two things. One is the area and one is the price. So we call area as the independent variable and the price as the dependent variable. Okay, this is the independent variable and this is the dependent variable. And the first thing is in machine learning, we have to identify which are all the independent variable, which are all the dependent variable. And then we are using here a linear regression because if you look at this data later on, you can see if the area increases, obviously the price increases, right? So if I want to buy a 30-40 site or a 40-60 site in a particular area, obviously the 40-60 have to pay more price, right? So that is what is the linear regression about. So we want to build a model, build an algorithm which can use the linear regression. This is what we wanted to do. So let us see how to get started with this. So I already have the program. Just I will open that program using a Jupyter notebook. So you can use Spider also, but you most of the times you people are using Jupyter Notebook. So this is the linear regression. So good thing about it is you can do the proper documentation and all in the Jupyter Notebook. So the, again, this is an example which you want to try. So we try to solve a problem of predicting the home price in a space, in a place, Monroe in New Jersey. So this is what. So if we try to draw a graph, see what is the problem statement? Given that the data, build a machine learning model to predict the home prices based on the square feet area. So if we try to draw a plot, see these are all the points. These are all the points. If you try to draw a graph of area versus price. So in linear regression, what we are trying to do is we are trying to draw a line which is the best fit where the predicted value, if I try to predict a value, for example, I try to predict a value for the 3600 and this is where I am going to get somewhere between 65,000 and 675. Okay, so this is the predictor. The difference between the actual value and the predicted value should be minimum. So that is what the algorithm we will be using linear regression. So what is the effort? Effort is to minimize the delta. We call it as the delta. That is the actual value and the predicted value and the square of the delta. So if I calculate all the actual value and all those things and then get the delta and then sum over it. So we wanted to see the best line fit which minimizes this value, because I can draw a line y is equal to mx plus v in different ways. The one best fit is the one which minimizes this particular value. So again, if you go back to your high school mathematics, where we can say y is equal to mx plus b, what is m? M is nothing but the slope, and y b is the intercept, right? B is the intercept. And then you can represent it like price is equal to m star area plus b, right? So this is what the algorithm is already built in using this. That is what we will be using here. So from the coding perspective, we have to import few of the libraries. What are the libraries? Pandas, NumPy. NumPy may not be required, but still. Scikit-learn, this is where the library, see linear model. So this has the algorithm, scikit-learn. And then the matplotlib, that is for plotting the graph. This is what we will be using. So first we try to read this data. This data is a CSV file, home prices, as I showed you. This data, I'm trying to read the data. This is what I'm getting. Now I want to separate out the independent variable, dependent variable. So I'm trying to get the price. I'm DF of price means I will get the price. Then I want to get the what is called as the area. How to get the area? So before that, let me try to plot. I will try to plot the graph of area versus price. This is what, how it would look like. Then what we are trying to do is we are trying to drop the price column to get the area separately, because we need a pandas data frame. So that's why my independent variable should be a data frame. So that is what I'm going to get the new data frame, which is nothing but my X value, and the Y value is nothing but the price. So using the linear model, using the linear regression, now I'm going to build this model, linear regression. So then this model, I'm trying to fit this data. So here what machine is going to learn is it is trying to try to learn from the data, and it tries to build this relationship, right? So that is where we are trying to fit this data, I mean the price and the area and the price. Then if you apply the score, see here there is a score method is there. So it has predicted or it has built the model with an accuracy of around 95%. So again, it depends on the data. And now if we try to superimpose that model, whatever was built with the data, so this is what we are going to get. So this is the predicted prices or the slope, and these are the data points. So this is what is the best fit line we would have got. We have a scatter plot on that. We plot the area plus the predicted value of the price. Okay, based on that, if we do, this is what we'll be getting. So this is an example of a linear regression, and now with that I can predict. Suppose if I pass the area of 3200, now my the price is 615,000, right? So that is how we can do the prediction, and we can also calculate the coefficient and the intercept. So here basically when we have the lot of data, so where this prediction comes into picture, this is a one of the example. Just I will tell you, I will take just 2 minutes and tell you the another example where there is a multilinear regression, because usually you cannot build the predict the price by just taking one parameter, right? So there will be multiple parameters. Suppose if I say multiple parameters, yeah, this is one of the example. The another example is like where you have the data like this, multiple variate. So in this case, it is not just the price and all, we can also add some other things. Like we can add, there are actually in real scenario, there are so many things. This is just for the demo purpose, like area, bedroom, age of the house or age of this thing, and then the price. So there could be multiple variables. So in these variables, what are these? Like area, bedroom, area, these are all the independent variable, and this is the dependent variable. This is one kind of a data set. Another thing could be, if you want to make it complex, we can also put the area. Okay, so we can also put the area and we try to understand the relationship like this. So the real data set would be something like this. If you can see, this is what we got from the real magic brick and all. So this, it can go complex like this. So many data. It all depends on the type of the house, availability, locations, size, society, total square feet, number of bathroom, balcony, and all those things. Okay, so this is quite some kind of a data which is there available, and then we can take this kind of thing, build a linear relationship model, and then we can predict. So in the next webinar, I will be showing the end to end with the data engineering, where I would be taking this example and building further. So to conclude today, just I introduced you what is called as a machine learning, and just to give an example of different kinds of machine learning, which is supervised machine learning, unsupervised machine learning, and then the reinforcement machine learning, and give just a glimpse of how to use, and also I told you about the bigger picture of the project and what you would be working on. So a lot of things are there in the machine learning, and just a introductory session in terms of just to get to know about what is the machine learning. So with that, thanks for hearing to me from last 50 minutes, and also thanks Kumar for arranging this webinar. Over to you. Kumar, over to you.
Okay, great. Thank you once again for delivering such a fantastic session. So this was the third session participants. So like if you want, so if anybody has missed out anything on the recording, are you able to hear me? Hello?
Yeah, we are able to hear, but its voice is breaking.
Okay, just a minute. Okay, fine. I think now that the line would be much better. So, all right. Thank you, sir, once again for delivering such a wonderful session. So, this was our third session. And people, you know, initially I showed where you can actually find the recording. And also below the chat section, there is a place called offer. There is a blue button where it will take you to the recording page where we have, you know, made all available of YouTube and Facebook links, so you can actually look at it. And moreover, what we are doing, Mr. Raghu is starting us with, Raghu will be our trainer for the machine learning training, the public batch, which we are going to start this Saturday, 17th onwards. So we have very limited seats, and for the participants, we have an offer which is running. So people can make use of it. So 17th is the day. So it's a weekend back, totally 6 weekends. You have to dedicate yourself 5 hours a day. And the actual price of this training is 14,750, but we have, for the webinar participants, it's 7,965. Okay, so people can enroll quickly, whoever is interested. And the recordings, if you want to show the screen again, I can show where you can actually go and find the recordings. So yes, I think my screen is getting, visible now. So if you go to our webpage, or maybe the link which is given below this chat section, there it will directly direct you to this page. Or else if you go to our website, skillupright.com, so this is the domain, skillupright.com, and there there is webinar recordings tab, and on the machine learning Python or AWS you can click. So so machine learning will take you here. So recordings are here for all the previous session. Today we will be uploading the links also over here of the Facebook and YouTube. You can access it. Right, and next session again we have next Wednesday, 21st. So we request you to join back, and the entire series you can enjoy, with the recordings and also the live sessions too. Okay, so this was the offer which I was talking about. So anybody interested, this weekend we have very limited seats. Anybody wants to join for the webinar participant, the offer is 7,965, which is inclusive of GST. Okay, so we have given almost 50% discount. Anybody, if you want to download the content, here is the place, and enrollment can happen here. We are going to do a virtual session. It's not a classroom at all. So Mr. Raghu will be connecting via Zoom or Google Meet, and he will be delivering the session. So if you look at our content, every module has a hands-on session. So he's going to do a hands-on. He's going to demo the concepts to you. He'll make you do in the class as well. And post that, you can practice with the help of the recordings, or if you want to refresh, the recordings will be made available for you. Anytime, like 1 year, 2 year, 3 year later also, you can go and check the recordings. So once you complete the training, we'll also be providing the certificate. And anybody has any questions on the webinar, on the sessions, this is my number and email address, you can reach me out. Okay, so all the recordings are made available here, guys. So once again, I just wanted to, so where the recordings are, if you have a question, that is, one is on the Facebook. So you can follow us on the Facebook page, and whenever any new recording we update, all those, today if you follow us, the next session's recordings notification also you'll get. Similarly with the YouTube link also, if you subscribe to our YouTube channel, any new recordings or anything that we upload on the YouTube, everything will be able to access it. If you subscribe to our YouTube channel. So the previous two sessions links are made available already here. Today, max, I think by 5 o'clock, the recordings should be ready. And if you come to this page, you will be able to access it. Or if you are already subscribed to Facebook or YouTube, you would get a notification as and when we upload the recording. So that's on my side. I'm not sure today there is any questions from the past.
There was one question I think Swapna Lil has asked. How to identify the dependent variable? So let me answer that question, and then I think that is the only one question. So that is where the data analysis parts comes into picture. That's what I told you, right? So machine learning is one of the part of the bigger project. So this is where we will be discussing with the business analyst and try to identify what is the impact. So if I take the again example, what is the impact? Why customers are moving from my particular telecom company and going to another company, right? So then a lot of things. So first we have to understand what kind of plan he is into. And a second point is how long he is into this. And the third thing is what are the competitor prices, right? So there could be so many reasons. So those data we have to get, and along with the business analyst, we have to decide what are the factors or what are the data points which is basically we wanted to explore further, which would help us in understanding the real problem. To make it short, there are two things. One is the output, what is the expected output, and the things which are all impacting the output. Okay, those are all the variables. And then again, there could be 100 variables. We have to identify which of them is causing a more impact. Okay, there are so many techniques that we'll be using here. And then we will be going ahead with those things. And some of the variables may not be required. We will take it out. And then the one which is really required, that we will be using. Yeah. I think that was the one of the question. I have not seen any other question. Kumar?
So, okay, sorry, I was on mute. So, all right, sir. Thank you for delivering again. One more machine learning session. So it was really good. Thank you for taking time out and sharing your knowledge to all the participants. So participants, next week again, same time we have another session. It's again going to be Bana session, exactly same Wednesday, same time. It's 21st October. You can connect back and join the webinar to get some more knowledge on the machine learning part. So that's all from our end. So anybody interested to join our training program, this Saturday the training program is going to start. So don't miss this offer. Please, quickly you can enroll whoever is interested. All right. Thank you so much for joining us. Take care. Be safe. We'll connect back next week again. And the participants who are joining the training program, we'll connect this Saturday.
Thank you. Thanks.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. Thank you once again.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Neha is asking, I don't receive. Neha has a question. I did not receive a certificate for completing the AWS Cloud Computing webinar. So for webinars, we are not providing any certificates. Only if you are attending a training program, you will be receiving the certificates. Great, guys. Thank you very much for joining in. So Dilip says, thank you. Sanjay also says, thank you. Swapnil, thanks. Okay, Donald, thank you. Great. All right, guys. I think it's already like 4 o'clock. I hope you guys have to get back to your work. And at the same time, we also have to get back to our work. So we'll connect back next week. Or if somebody is joining for our training program, we can connect them on Saturday. So till then, take care, be safe.